Wow, this place is incredible.
Where do you want to set up?
Somewhere not by people. Here's good.
You don't feel creeped out here? What with how that girl got eaten here by a shark?
Of course not. That's why I wanted to come here.
What? You're trying to get eaten by a shark?
No, and even if I was, lightning that rare doesn't strike twice. Shark attacks practically never happen.
So then, why did I drive you all the way here from Jersey?
Because I'm beautiful. And because you're my best friend and have been since kindergarten, you do anything for me.
Yeah? Why here? Why this place?
Okay, you took me here, no questions asked, so I'll tell you. But you can't laugh, okay?
Okay.
Remember that chick who died here? Remember her photo in the news?
I don't know. Maybe?
You definitely do. She was hot. A perfect 10. A 9 in the photo they used of her, a school photo, but a 10 in all the corpse pictures on the internet. Besides the gore, of course.
You'll look those up?
Don't judge me. You're a boy. I'm sure you look at worse online.
I don't. At all.
Well, hooray for you. The point is, I saw her beauty, and I figured that if she died here, some of her molecules might still be in this water. This is a pretty placid place. I don't think the ocean could have carried her out far. If you swim here, you're definitely gonna absorb some of her nutrients in your skin.
You want that?
Yeah, I want to absorb some of her beauty.
I never would have taken you here if I'd known that was what you wanted to do.
Hey, celebrities inject aborted fetus goop into their skin in order to stay beautiful. That's a fact I read about in an article on the internet. They're sick. I would never do that. I just want to bathe in a babe.
That's the grossest thing you have ever said to me.
Hey, I'm not here just for me. You could use some of her and you more than I could.
Ouch.
I'm just saying, you were a lot hotter at the start of high school than you are now.
You thought I was hot? Ever?
Yeah. You had a moment. You definitely could have gotten with me back then.
I could have?
I'll tell you what. If you go in the water with me, and let me pick your next haircut, and get you some new clothes, then maybe I'll let you be my boyfriend for a little bit.
Really?
Really? Billy, it's time we took this friendship to the next level. Privately, at least. I don't know that I could ever announce publicly we're together.
I mean, yeah, that's fine. I'd be happy to have you at all, Carrie.
I know you would. Anyone would, but especially you.
Well, I mean, I love you.
I know. And I've come to realize I should take way more advantage of that than I do. You already do so much for me as a friend. Imagine how much you'll do for me as a boyfriend.
Anything. Literally anything.
So then let's go get that babe's cells into our skin.
Okay.
She's kind of warm. She feels good.
Yeah, she does.
Whoa. Are you hard? Did your thing just poke me from all the way over there? Are you hung, Billy?
No.
Oh. Well, something just brushed my leg.
I don't see anything down there.
Ow! Something just bit my hand!
Stop joking around.
I'm not joking! Is there a mark? What happened to me? Where's my hand?
I don't know. Ah! Something just bit my legs. My legs. My legs are gone. I'm sinking.
It's spreading.
Invisible shark!
Did anybody else just see that?
What's up?
Those people, they just disappeared.
Who?
The people whose stuff that is.
I don't see any stuff. Maybe they packed up and left.
Hey, sing, who, what? We're standing at the edge of the stage, basking in your pain. Sing that motherfucker for you. Sing it for me. When truth collides with revisionist attitude, we will not place blame. We will seek a higher plane. I wanna love me, but I don't know how. I wanna leave this life.
Again. First time in a while, but it happened again. The dream of that day, exactly as it happened that day. It really surprised me this time. I think because I was having such a nice dream right before it. I was with Colby, still with him, I guess, in the dream. I was wearing a bra and undies, the same color as what I was wearing on that fateful day. And I think that was enough to slip me into dreaming about it. I knew what the dream meant, of course. I didn't like it. But I knew what I had to do today. I had to go to a meeting.
Hey, it's Brooke. Where's it at today?
Let's all join hands. Thank you all for coming out today. Once again, we join together at a beach because we will not be consumed by fear. We will not shy away. We give thanks for our gift. A gift which at times makes us uncomfortable, and at times brings us derision from ignorant others. But we will not apologize for our perceptivity. We know that what we see is real.
Amen.
I wonder if I could go first, Jewel?
Go right ahead, Douglas.
I have a few new additions to what I think has been going on here, and,
I like Douglas. He's the brains of the bunch. What brains he has left after being all consumed by a hunt for meaning, an explanation as to what the invisible shark is and why it eats the people that it eats and why only we can see those people.
Brooke, you haven't joined us in quite a while. Is there anything that you'd like to share?
No, not really. I just had a dream last night about my encounter.
I hate when that happens.
Please, tell us about it.
I think I'm good. I thought it would be nice to be around you all today so I didn't feel so alone. You've all heard my story 1,000 times anyway. I'm sure you're tired of it. Someone else can go.
You could share how the dream made you feel.
It made me feel the same that it always does. It made me feel crappy.
Can you describe crappy?
Can I describe crappy? Like shit. It made me feel like shit.
I'd like to apologize for Brooke's choice of language.
Well, is this what it's like here now? I've been gone for 3 months and suddenly we can't curse anymore?
We've had a lot of younger people join us lately.
Who? I just see the same faces I've always seen.
They haven't exactly stuck around.
Yeah, I could see why. If we can't be honest with each other, then what's the point? You know what? This was a mistake. I forgot how not for me this is. I've never even liked these. Have fun going around in circles.
We're here if you need us. Any one of us is always a call away.
I'm better off on my own.
Yo, you got a light? Didn't I see you over on the beach earlier telling it to those invisible shark freaks earlier? Good for you. Those people disgust me.
Why do they disgust you?
Because they're nuts.
Nuts people disgust you?
No, not normal nuts people. Not people who can't help it. But invisible shark people definitely disgust me. They're faking it for attention. Or maybe it's a code or something. I don't know. It's just gross.
You're gross.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Screw you, lady. I hope your foot falls off from all that sugar.
How about I fall it off into your ass?
What? Yeah, okay. That was a good little comeback. But screw you.
Screw you, too.
Listen, how about I buy you another soda?
Leave me alone.
All right, diabetes-ass bitch.
I'm actually not a bitch, is the thing. Anyone who has ever gotten close to me in any capacity might disagree. From strangers to fellow invisible shark attack seers to exes, but I know in my heart that I'm not one. There was a time in my life when I was a really sweet person, the vast majority of my life actually, but people thinking you're crazy changes you. It just feels like fuck it anymore. What was it all for? Being nice. If like a light switch, everyone is gonna suddenly see you like there's something wrong with you, just because you can see what they can't see.
Excuse me, miss?
Don't talk to that woman.
He can ask me a question if he wants.
No, he can't. Okay, he shouldn't be talking to people.
Excuse me, miss?
Yo, what'd I just say?
What can I help you with?
Do you know if there's, a group that comes out here to talk about the invisible shark?
Yeah, there is actually. I think they're all done for the day, though. Yeah, I don't see them anymore. Sorry.
Oh. Do you want to see my invisible shark drawings?
She don't want to see your invisible shark drawings.
I would love to see them. What's your name?
Carlisle.
That's not your name.
It's my name.
Your name is Lyle.
My name is Lyle, but I put a car in front of it because I like cars.
I think that's wonderful. That's very creative.
Yeah, you saw Carlisle on a building or something one day, and now he just tells everyone his name is Carlisle. So.
Well, I think that's wonderful.
Okay.
These are my shark drawings.
Oh, wow. These are wonderful.
I draw them in white crayon.
Yeah, I can feel that.
No, you can't. He doesn't even use white crayons, okay? Those are just blank pages. He doesn't draw anything.
Are you his older brother, or...
Do I sound like his older brother? Do I sound like I have what he has? Okay, ain't no blood relation here. I'm just paid to be, all right? I'm on the clock. I'm making money.
Have you ever seen the invisible shark?
I have, actually.
Really?
Don't lie to him. Ain't nobody seen that shit.
I have seen one.
And how would you even know? Huh? It's invisible. I mean, think about it.
I was in its presence.
This fucking lady, I swear to God, this fucking lady.
I've always wanted to see one. I believe in it. I think it's real.
I think it's real too.
All right, we're done here. Let's go.
What was it like?
It was completely invisible. And it bit two people that only I could see. And the bites made them completely disappear.
Lyle.
No, Liv, I don't want to go.
Come on. See what you did? All of this because of some made up bullshit. Thanks a lot, lady.
Fuck this beach.
No, Mom, I haven't found a new job yet. Of course I'm looking. Why wouldn't I be looking? No, not every day. Nobody looks every day. I need to do other things sometimes. Well, today I had to go to the beach. I had to go to the beach, you know why. Yes, I know I don't tan. Thanks, Mom. I didn't go to the beach to tan. I said I had to go to the beach, okay? Listen to my words. Read between the lines. Yes, exactly. I went to a meeting. It was fine. It was great. Helped me a lot. The pills are helping too. Yes. Listen, Mom, I just got home. Can I call you back later? No, I'm not gonna look for jobs right now. I'm gonna eat. I'm gonna eat food, Mom. I'm gonna eat dinner. Okay, fine. Goodbye. this shit. Brooke, thank you for your inspiration. Hope you enjoy this screener copy. It should be on streaming and in big box stores this fall.
Chuck, the invisible shark will get you.
I have to destroy the invisible shark.
You're so brave.
Thank you. I have to destroy the invisible shark.
Get them. My gosh, yay! It's still alive. Oh no. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I got the copy of the DVD your company sent over yesterday. I watched it last night. Yeah, it was interesting. It was silly, yeah. Anyway, I was told that I'd get paid when the film was done, and I just got the DVD of it, which means it's done, so I was wondering when I'll get paid. It was one of the producers who said I'd get paid. I don't remember their name. It was whoever contacted me. You probably have a record of it somewhere. How do I know they said I'd get paid? I know, because that's the only reason I would have agreed to sharing the story of my encounter with you for your research, which honestly I don't think you even needed, because the film is just a bunch of made-up stupid shit. No, my story was used. You know the based on a true story that shows at the beginning of the movie? That's my story that's referring to. What do you mean, based on a true story doesn't necessarily refer to me? I know like every single fucking person who's seen an invisible shark attack. And it's a small community. I know for a fact that none of them share their stories with you. Only I did. Well then take the based on a true story off the front of the film. I no longer consent to you using my story for the basis of your whatever. I'm aware that liberties were taken. Yes, I just told you that you took liberties with my story. I no longer consent to you using what I told you. Okay, well, can I get something? Anything at all, like $50 or something? Okay, how about $20? Like something, anything. Yeah, a couple of copies of the DVD is fine. That'll be fine. Hi, this is Brooke calling. I'm a person who's seen an invisible shark attack. You have been trying to get me on your invisible shark podcast for a while now, and I think I'm finally ready to do it. I think you said it'd pay $100, so if that's still the offer, then I'll come on. So yeah, just let me know if you're still interested. Thanks. Bye.
Thank you so much for coming. We're so excited to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. You're not wearing a bikini, though.
Oh, I brought one, like you asked. I just didn't want to wear it on the subway, you know?
Why not? It's perfectly legal.
Good to know. Yeah, I just didn't want to, though, but I can put it on now if you want. If you have a bathroom I can change in.
Oh, yeah, you could go change. Just change now, because we're going to get started soon.
Just another few minutes.
This is embarrassing, but which one of you is Jenny and which one of you is Penny?
I'm Jenny and she's Penny, and it's not embarrassing at all. They're fake names, so sometimes we get them mixed up ourselves.
You do. I don't.
So, is the show live?
No. We edit all of the episodes.
Cool.
Because sometimes I pull out her tits or she pulls out my tits and we gotta censor it, you know?
Okay. I don't want my tits pulled out, for the record.
I'm just fucking with you. There are no tits that are gonna be pulled out. But yeah, we edit the episodes.
Okay. So, how many fans do you guys have?
What are we up to now?
We get like 100,000 views an episode.
Wow, that's incredible. Congratulations.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
I didn't know there were that many people out there interested in this phenomenon.
Yeah, I mean, there are some people who are genuinely into it. I mean, we're genuinely interested. And some of the viewers, they seem to be genuinely interested as well.
Mostly people like looking at two weird girls in bikinis, but I think some are genuinely into it.
Hey, whatever pays the bills, right?
Oh, no, it doesn't pay the bills. But it's our passion, you know? And we really believe in the Invisible Shark. And that's why we are very stoked to have you here. All right, so do you have any theories about the Invisible Shark?
Not really my own theories, but Douglas Robert Anderson's theories. Do you know him?
We love Douglas. He's been on the show before.
Yeah, Douglas is great. I know him from the meetings.
Oh, that's great. You know, we would go to the meetings, but we know they're really only for people who've like witnessed an invisible shark attack, so we want to respect y'all's space and everything.
Yeah, thanks. I don't really have much to say about the meetings. I don't really go to them that much anymore. It's not really my thing.
That's cool. So why don't you tell us about Douglas Anderson's theories, maybe for those who might not know about them?
Sure. Well, he could probably explain this a lot better than I could, but the gist of it is that because the ocean is so huge and 80% of it is completely unexplored, of course there are animals that we don't even know about and animals that we can't even conceive of, ones that defy the imagination of what an animal could be, but nonetheless are intrinsic to how our world operates. He likes to use that word a lot, intrinsic.
Yeah, he does that. He got us to say it. We say intrinsic a lot now.
Yeah, so basically he sees the invisible shark as like, and this is where it gets a little complicated, but like, as human consciousness evolved to be able to conceive of parallel universes, so too then has the natural world been able to evolve to balance out the problems that arise from the evolution of human consciousness. So, like, there's this theory called the observer effect in quantum physics, where until you observe a tiny particle, it is not yet a tiny particle. So Douglas thinks that maybe it's the same with what, you know, the human mind can conceive of, that until it conceives of something, it doesn't exist. And so in that way, we kind of create parallel universes. I mean, the universe assembled itself that way due to, you know, our consciousness creating that possibility.
I'm sorry, I just have to say you are explaining this so well right now.
Yeah. Oh my God, thank you. I was worried I was butchering it.
No, you're doing great.
Thank you. So yeah, like, basically Douglas made a chart of reported invisible shark attacks, and he made a chart of human interest in parallel universes over time. And he found that they both line up perfectly. I mean, they both increase at the same rate over time. And so his theory is basically that the invisible shark is a creature that evolved alongside our consciousness expansion, that it protects the Earth from any sort of glitch that arises and, you know, arises from parallel universes. It corrects for people that shouldn't be here, who somehow leaked into here. I mean, it's like two jigsaw puzzles, and some pieces from one jigsaw puzzle gets mixed in with the pieces from the other puzzle. And the invisible shark, you know, what it does is it lures these people, these missing puzzle pieces, to the ocean somehow, and it erases them from our reality to, you know, keep the balance and protect our world.
So cool.
Yeah, so like, I don't know. I like that theory. I mean, I'm one of those people that can see these extra people somehow through an extrasensory receptor or whatever. But yeah, I like his theory because, you know, I like the idea that the invisible shark is doing good for our world, that, you know, it's our protector.
Yeah, no, we like it too. We like it because it makes it, like, what's the word? Like, benevolent, right?
Benevolent.
Benevolent, yeah. All right, so we usually like to wrap up our show with a few questions from the viewers. So if you don't mind, can we ask you some viewer questions now?
Sure.
Okay, awesome. Penny, will you do the honors?
Sure, Jenny. All right, so first question is, if the invisible shark is invisible, how do you know it's a shark? We get this one a lot, but we'd love to hear your take on it.
Sure, yeah, and I get this a lot in my own life too. I guess my answer is that the people who are being attacked by the invisible shark call it the invisible shark, so we just call it that. But yeah, technically, it could be something else. I mean, there's no way we can know for sure. You know, the invisible shark doesn't have to be a shark, per se.
Yeah, that's basically our theory as well.
Cool. Okay, next question. This is another we get a lot. Everyone's always talking about it like it's one shark, but how do you know it's not multiple sharks?
Yeah, so again, I mean, there's no way to know for sure. But because we've never seen two attacks happen at the same time, we just use the singular when we refer to it.
Our answer too. Okay, this next one I don't think we've ever gotten before. It's, has having seen an invisible shark impacted your dating life at all?
Can I pass on any of these? Sorry.
Yeah, we could cut that question out. That's fine.
Thanks.
Okay, next one. How has having seen an invisible shark benefited your life for the better or for the worse?
For the better or for the worse? Sorry, what was the question again?
How has having seen an invisible shark benefited your life for the better or for the worse?
It's worded weird, I think.
Yeah, I think that's what's throwing me off. Sorry.
Just answer it, I guess, as best as you can.
Yeah. I wanna go back to that other question, actually. My answer is that it has not affected my dating life right now because I do not date. But it has affected my love life because I loved a man, and he couldn't accept me for who I was. He didn't believe in the invisible shark, and that's my answer. I don't know if he's watching this, or listening to this. Maybe he's not, but I loved him. He was a good man. He was always good to me, but he couldn't believe. So yeah, that's my answer.
I'm so sorry that happened to you.
Thank you. I'll skip the other question, the stupidly worded one. Just give me another question.
Yeah. Next question. Do you currently take any drugs to deal with seeing invisible sharks? And how do you feel about those who do or don't do that?
I'm not answering that.
I don't blame you. Sorry about that.
Why are these, like, why are these not fluffy and chill? Like, why am I being thrown hardballs?
I'm sorry. We just use whatever comes in, but we could cut all of these out.
Thank you. But keep my answer to the dating question, and you can cut the rest.
Okay.
But the thing is, like, you can cut out what I tell you to cut out, but, you know, it still happened to me. I mean, you can take it out from the recording, but it doesn't change the fact that I'm sitting here and I'm having a bad fucking experience right now.
I'm sorry. I should have chosen better questions.
It's fine. It's fine. It's just frustrating, you know?
We're very sorry.
Leave the dating question and my answer to that, though, okay?
Mm-hmm. No problem.
It's not going to change the edit. Is it going to turn out, like, choppy or something?
No, yeah. You know, Penny will just cut to an ad at that part, whatever. It'll be fine.
Okay, cool. Then can we just be done now? Like, can we wrap this up?
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
Yeah. All right, Brooke, thank you so much for being on our show.
Thank you for having me.
I didn't know what to do after the podcast, where to go, how to spend the rest of my day. Nothing made the remotest of sense except for being at the beach. I was dressed for it, of course. I didn't even change my clothes, I was so out of it. I just hopped on the Q train, still in my bikini, and came out to Brighton.
Hi, do you have a moment to talk about God?
I'm not the right person to talk to about God.
Well, if that's how you feel, then I say you're the exact right person to talk about God.
You're good. That's clever. But to give you an idea of what I believe in an invisible shark, so yeah.
And how does believing in an invisible shark contrast with the belief in God?
Well, I believe that an invisible shark protects our world in a way more direct way than God ever does.
How does the invisible shark protect us?
I literally just came from a podcast where I went over all of this, and I'm spent. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
That's okay. Would you like to talk about God instead?
No, I do not. You're barking up the wrong tree, man. Sorry.
I don't know if I believe in wrong trees to bark up. I find your unique belief intriguing, so maybe something brought us to this conversation. My name is Darren, by the way.
Your hand feels different.
Maybe it is imbued with my faith.
Maybe.
Hey, do you know if there's anywhere I could get, like, a hot dog around here?
No. No, I don't. Sorry.
No worries.
Hey, wait. This is a weird question, but am I talking to a man right now?
No. I'm a woman.
No, I don't mean you. I mean, am I talking to a man right now? Like, right here.
Are you serious?
Nope, there's no man right there. Are you all right?
I'm fine. Thanks for your help.
Yeah, no worries.
You know, you don't have to talk to me if you don't want to, but it's not very nice to play games with me.
I want to talk. I very much want to talk. What was your name again?
Darren.
Darren, I can't believe we're having this conversation right now. I mean, we never get to have a conversation with people like you.
Well, I'd like to answer any questions you might have about God.
No, you don't understand. Darren, you're invisible. The only people who can see you are me and the people who have the gift that I have. In a minute, you're going to want to go to the water for some reason. For some weird reason, and an invisible shark is going to eat you and erase you from this reality. You're not supposed to be here.
I don't think I'll go in the water just like this.
What are your memories like? What do you remember from the reality that you came from? I want to know everything about what it's like to be you.
I like my life. I love God.
But do you remember anything before being at the beach here today?
I'm sure I must.
It's okay. Some people like you do, and some people like you don't. But did you talk to anyone?
I don't think so.
And you don't remember anything? You've no memories whatsoever?
I remember God.
That's wonderful. But this is not your reality. You don't belong here. Do you understand?
But what did I do wrong? All I do, and all I want to do, is spread the word of God.
I'm sure you're a good person. It's not about that.
But why am I being punished?
You're not being punished. You didn't do anything wrong. This is just an error, a glitch.
Thank you for showing me the light.
Darren.
Darren, you don't have to go to the water. You can sit here and talk to me. We can find out what it's like to be in your situation.
That night, I could barely fall asleep. And then when I finally did...
I heard you can talk to people that should not be here.
But you're a ghost. I've never talked to a ghost.
You know who I am?
You're that girl Brandy who was eaten by the shark on Plum Beach. I looked you up after I heard about you.
It wasn't a traditional shark that ate me.
It was an invisible shark? But you didn't disappear. You were a corpse.
There are more sharks out there other than actual sharks and invisible sharks.
Like what? What else?
No shark.
No shark. How is no shark a shark? How is no shark a shark?
I thought you were enlightened. I was mistaken.
Wait, don't go!
The dream had unnerved me hard, but I wasn't sure what had unnerved me about it the most. That I had spoken to a ghost, or that it appears I'm not as smart as I thought I was. I had no idea what she, or my subconscious, was trying to tell me. That morning, for the first time, I wished my pills were real and not just sugar pills. I guess I can confess this here, because no one will ever read any of this. Many of us with our gift have loved ones who don't understand us, and so we get prescriptions for our condition in order to make said loved ones who don't understand us feel better. Then we just switch them out with sugar lookalikes that one of us, who is a pharmacy student, makes for us for a reasonable fee.
Here's that book I thought you might like.
Oh. Thank you. And here are those mints I've been telling you about.
Oh, wow. So, how's things?
Oh, you know. Still fucking the non-seer, non-believer.
You're a moron.
I know, but... I know.
Never works.
Our dating pool is just shit, okay? The only single eligible straight guy is Douglas.
Why can't a hot young straight guy share a gift?
I know, right? He'd be knee-deep in all of us. All of us gifted ladies would just share him willingly and knowingly out of consideration that he's such a rarity.
Anyway, I've gotta go, but that book might actually be pretty good.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I picked it up out of a box on the street and flipped through the pages on the subway. Wasn't half bad.
Sweet. Thank you.
Thanks for everything, Abby.
Anytime, Brooke.
I sell the real pills to this guy, Max, that lives in my building. I say this guy, Max, but he's a friend, I guess. We can hang fairly comfortably. I don't know what he does with the pills. Probably trades them for whatever his drug of choice is. We're not close enough for me to know what drug that is.
I don't know what you're talking about. This Invisible Shark movie is good.
Glad you're enjoying it.
You guys should not be on this beach right now.
Hey,
I'm
a marine
biologist scientist.
The blonde?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know her, but I saw her on the beach the other day, and she asked me where she could find a hot dog.
I know where she could find a hot dog.
And there's an invisible shark on the loose.
Screw you, lady. This is my livelihood.
Yes, screw you, lady. This is her livelihood.
Yeah, screw you, lady. This is her livelihood.
Please, ladies, you're in danger of dying from invisible shark bites. Listen to science.
Listen to this.
Can you bring me a copy of this?
They're sending me some real ones in the mail, so I'll just give you one when they get here.
Can you print me one in the meantime, though?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. I'll give you extra for the pills as thanks if you want.
I'll say no to that.
I just really like this movie a lot.
Clearly.
Seeing that blonde again, her name is Rochelle, according to the end credits, by the way. Her actual name, not the character she played in the movie. Anyway, seeing her again made me suddenly want a hot dog, and a proper one. So I went to Coney Island, but then when I got there, I didn't really want a hot dog anymore. And so I suddenly had no reason to be there, as it was the only reason I had come there. There wasn't even a meeting going on, as far as I could see, so I couldn't just stumble into one of those. I felt aimless and without purpose, but then I saw her, and I suddenly realized why I was supposed to come here today.
Hey, Abby, it's Brooke. That fucking fraud bitch Rhonda is back at Coney Island. Call me when you get this. I'm the only one of us here. I'm probably gonna yell at her and be a cunt and stuff.
You see, the thing about seeing invisible people is, it's a spiritual experience. It's a beautiful thing. Would you like to hear about what it's like to see invisible people? I accept tips.
I'm sure you do. How about this for a tip? Get out of here. No one wants you here.
I'm sorry. We who can see are sometimes attacked for our gift.
This woman has no gift other than taking money from unsuspecting people.
Her name is Rhonda, and she is a known phony. And we who actually have the gift that she claims to be able to have told her to go away so many times.
I don't like how you're treating her. This is a public beach, and she can be here if she wants to.
She can't, actually. She's not allowed to do this on the beach. Even if she were for real, she would not be allowed to be doing this.
All she's doing is sharing her truth.
Her truth?
And I don't think you or I should be telling her, a woman of color, that she can't do something.
Are you seriously trying to make this into a race thing? This woman is a fraud! She doesn't come to any of our meetings. She hasn't tested any of her abilities against our abilities.
That's not how my gift works. It can't be tested. It comes and it goes.
Bullshit! That's not what it's like. You have no idea what it's like.
I think you should leave.
Fine. You're happy talking to her? Fine. Give her as much money as you want. It's your money. But please know, there are actual people who can actually do what she claims to do. And we have no money. We are flat broke. Our gift affects us, hurts us, curses us. We are tormented by our gift because people think we're full of shit. On top of that, we have to deal with people like this woman.
I'm going to give you an even bigger tip because I'm so sorry that you have to deal with this persecution.
Are you kidding me?
Thank you for your generosity.
You're seriously giving her more money after what I just said to you?
Please, continue.
As I was saying, seeing invisible people is a very spiritual experience.
I'm just invisible to both of you.
It's a beautiful thing. It's a centering experience, seeing invisible people.
You know what? Fuck you both. Fuck everyone. Just fuck everything.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Thank you.
I'm Chase.
Brooke.
Nice to meet you. I've seen you around here once or twice and at some other beaches near here.
Yeah, I go to beaches sometimes.
Me too.
Cool.
All right, I'm just gonna ask. Are you into women by any chance?
No, I'm not into women.
I had to ask. You're very beautiful.
Thank you. I've actually never been hit on by a woman before. And you're a particularly good-looking woman, so thank you. But I'm not into women. And you wouldn't want me even if I were. Trust me.
Why not?
Because I'm kind of a freak.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, I don't mean... I'm not into freaky stuff. I'm just a weird person.
Ah, I see.
Yeah, like, you know those people who can see invisible shark attacks?
Yeah, I've heard of those people. You're one of them?
Yeah. Yeah, like I said, I'm kind of a freak.
You know, I used to think those people were crazy, but I remember this one time I was on Reese Beach, and I saw someone I could have sworn was invisible, a ghost, something. He was a brute of a man in a green shirt with glasses like mine.
Gene. You're talking about Gene. How do you know about Gene?
What?
Did someone put you up to this?
No.
Gene was an invisible person who we tried to talk to once, and when they told him his fate, he just decided to never go in the water. Now he just roams the sands of Reese Beach in a sort of self-imposed limbo. And he keeps quiet. He never talks to us when we try to talk to him. He mostly just stares at visible people. Women, mostly. It's a beautiful beach, but we don't go there anymore because he gives us the creeps.
Are you fucking with me?
No, are you fucking with me?
No, that story's real?
Yes.
Fuck. Yeah, he was definitely creepy. Anyway, I only saw him for a minute. It was just a glimpse.
Fuck.
What?
I believe you. Fuck. Fuck.
Why fuck?
Because I'm an asshole. I literally just called a woman a fraud for being able to do exactly what you're describing, and which I believe you about. So maybe she wasn't full of shit. Maybe she was telling the truth. So fuck. We've been so horrible to her. So many of us have yelled at her, given her shit, got her kicked off the beach. Fuck, I've gotta go.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I've gotta go. Fuck.
I looked around for Rhonda after. I wanted to apologize to her. I wanted to talk to her, but I couldn't find her anywhere. Finally, I just gave up and went home. My heart was racing all the way back, and even when I got in, it wouldn't stop. I felt like I wanted to cry, but the tears wouldn't come. I wanted to be held. I wanted to be held, and I wanted to be stroked. I wanted Colby back.
Hey, Colby, it's Brooke. I need you to come hold me. Call me when you get this.
He called back quickly after and said he'd be over right away. He didn't say it in a horny way. He said it with genuine caringness and understanding. His touch was even better than I had remembered it, even better than in dreams I'd had of it. It was so good that I kept wanting his hand to drift to areas of me that would make the touch sexual, but he wouldn't do it. And then he kissed me. Just a light one on my forehead, but I didn't let his head leave. His kiss was as sweet as his touch, and as he kissed me, his hand finally moved to the parts of me that I was dying for him to move his hand to. The fucking had been lovemaking, and undeniably so. I wasn't prepared for that, emotionally. I felt suddenly stuck, like I had fallen down a well. We were together again. Even if it remained unspoken for the rest of our lives, we were together again. Because I am not a man, and thus I cannot let something I feel sit unspoken within me for the rest of my life, I said something about it. I voiced my concern about what this night might mean for us. He reminded me that it was I who had ended things between us, and not him, as though I had forgotten that, which, of course, I had not. But to be honest, I probably didn't think about that specific fact too often. It was too hard to.
You couldn't deal with me not believing, whereas I could deal with you believing. I still can deal with you believing. I've no problem with you believing. I never have.
But you not believing too means you think I'm crazy.
That's not true. You always do this. You always bring it to this. I've never once said that you are crazy. Even when we've argued, I've never said that.
But you think it's all in my head.
I think it might be in your head and everyone else's head who experiences this. The key word being might. I'm agnostic on this. I always have been. I've always made that clear. If it's real, it'll be discovered one day scientifically. It will be proven. It will be, rigorous study needs to happen. You know what I mean? Like, and on that day, when it's really proven, I will believe. Of course I will believe. But the science needs to happen. The science needs to happen.
Nothing was resolved by the discussion, the argument, the whatever it was that I had initiated, instigated. The only thing that was clear in my head by the end of it was that I didn't want him to go. I wanted him to stay here, at least for the night. I didn't know what we were, but I wanted to wake up with him. And not just in that I didn't want to wake up alone. I wanted it to be him, specifically, that I woke up with. Despite our differences, I wanted that.
Hey, do you like books?
I'm not interested, sorry.
You don't even know what's in here yet.
I don't care.
I've been studying the phenomena of the invisible shark. Have you ever heard of that?
Yeah, it's stupid.
It won't be stupid when it comes for you. When it comes for everybody.
I woke up that morning and saw him watching Invisible Shark, enjoying it. I watched a little. This was now my third time watching it.
That woman just arrived. We better warn her.
Yeah, she could die.
Knowing what we know, it's our job to keep her safe.
Yeah, she's a sitting duck.
Yeah, it's like quack quack over there.
Lady, there's an invisible shark at the beach.
Yeah, lady, and when it bites you, your body parts disappear.
And then slowly, the rest of you will disappear, lady.
Yeah, lady, you're in grave danger.
Like a literal grave, lady.
First of all, stop calling me lady. I have a name. My name is L.
What's the L stand for? Lady?
But seriously, you're gonna die. You need to go.
You're gonna die. If you don't leave me alone.
All right, fine, lady. We tried. Good luck.
His enjoyment of it quickly rubbed off on me, and this time I actually enjoyed the movie. The attacks are pretty accurate, I will admit. They got those right. The scenarios are ridiculous, but they got the attacks right. And seeing the attacks in the context of a cheesy B-movie is probably healing in some way. It makes one realize the silliness in all things. This mortal coil is nothing to be afraid of. This mortal coil is just a funnel cake or something, topped with powdered sugar. That's the best I can describe it. After the movie, I switched over to regular TV, and that's when we heard the news. Our phones had apparently been blowing up the entire time we'd been watching, but they were on silent, so we learned what had happened in the very old-school way of from the TV. I, and everyone like me, had now been legitimized. The government had announced that the invisible shark was real. They had tracked it to Plum Beach overnight, and they had successfully destroyed it using cutting-edge firepower. The invisible shark was real, and the invisible shark was dead. Gone. Kaput. Colby felt differently in my arms. He had just learned the truth about how the government and scientists actually behave when faced with that which they do not understand. I'm sure I felt differently in his arms, too. I wasn't his ideological opposite anymore. but his closest, nearest ally. It was us, the people, against the destructive, uncaring, unthinking, authoritarian machine. Admittedly, it was nice that my government had finally confirmed that I was not a nut. But at what cost? As far as I or anyone like me could figure, the invisible shark had been doing the Lord's work. With it dead, gone, people who don't belong here would have nowhere to go. They would be stuck here forever, and we who could see them would be stuck seeing them, and there would be nothing we could do about it. There's always something that can be done, though, Colby said to me when I told him how I felt. There's always something that can be done. And he was right.
See that guy over by the rocks?
With the blue shirt?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, what about that girl? Blonde hair, pink bathing suit?
Yep.
Are you kidding me?
I see them.
What about that young woman right there? Tattoos?
What young woman?
Right there. She's sitting right next to us. Do you not see her?
No, there's no one there.
Really?
Yeah.
Tattoos? You don't see any young woman with tattoos?
No.
Looks like we got one. Thanks.
No problem.
Hi. Is this your first time at Plum Beach?
Yeah, I've never been here before. It's great.
Yeah, it's a great place. Have you been in the water yet?
No, I'm kind of scared to, after what happened.
The invisible shark that they killed.
Yeah, I mean, there's probably all sorts of, like, chemicals and shit from whatever they shot at it. And the water's just so placid, you know? It'd probably just stay there.
Yeah, that's a good point. I hadn't thought about that. Well, luckily you don't have to go in.
It's true. I can just admire it.
Yes, you can. It's beautiful water.
It is.
Hey, can I get your back?
Oh, with sunscreen.
Yeah.
Shit, could you? I probably didn't get it good enough.
No problem.
Thanks. My sunscreen's in my bag behind me.
All right.
What happened here?
Nothing.
Is this from the knife?
Yeah, I just accidentally cut my finger. It's nothing. It's nothing. The point is she's gone, so it's...
She's gone. She dissolved fully away?
Yeah, she dissolved fully away.
It looked like you did a good job.
You think so?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I thought so myself.
Yeah, I'm proud of you.
You're proud of
me? Yeah, I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You know... You and I make a good team.
We do. You want to do this more often?
Yeah, of course I do.
If you heard of Invisible Shark, it's the biggest story in town. Commemorative t-shirts right here.
How much are they?
I'll call it 2 for $25.
How about one for her? How much for one?
Okay, we can do that. Let's make it... $1 for $15.
$1 for $15, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
We'll take one.
Good.
What's the size on that one?
Oh, it's a small.
Okay.
That should be good on her.
Yeah, that should work.
I take all major payment apps.
What about cash? Do you take cash?
Oh, man, you went old school on me, bro.
Do you take cash?
Yeah, still? Cash is good. It's cool.
Okay. All right. 15.
Man, I like your style, bro. Yeah, most people don't do this.
I'm still with the cash.
Yeah, old school. I like that, man. I'm a cash man myself, too. Look at that.
Does it look good?
It's good.
Yeah, I love it.
Looks good. Feels good.
Thank you. Right. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you two enjoy your beautiful day at the beach, man. See you guys later.
Thank you.
You take too. Care. Does it look good?
Yeah, it looks good.
Thank you.
make my heart pound rapid like a hummingbird. I love her. Behind her gray eyelids, I can feel my future now. Friend, most wield the word like a weapon. Fuck that. Curse the wasted mornings when I slept in. I would rise with the sun just to see our naked arms entwined. Slim chance, so I'm ignoring the odds. I will crush that, shooting through me like a lightning rod. I am energy boundless, the limit is lifted. I know that death is a promise to her, my life I'll entrust. Oh, please let the goddess smile down upon us. I'll give her everything.